The Joint Strike Fighter, or JSF, program is intended to replace a wide range of existing combat aircraft for the United States and several international partners. After a tough competition among several major U.S. manufacturers, a specific company and aircraft were selected for the program, the F-35, produced by Lockheed Martin. And so, here are a few interesting things to know about this expensive fighter jet program. First, there was tough competition among manufacturers. Initial studies supporting the JSF program began in 1993, and the Department of Defense, or DoD, requested major manufacturers to submit their proposals for the new JSF. Four major manufacturers, including McDonnell Douglas, Northrop, Lockheed, and Boeing, proposed different aircraft designs, primarily based on short-slash-vertical takeoff and landing, or S-slash-VTOL, capabilities. There were two contract awards. Lockheed Martin and Boeing were awarded prototype contracts, and each company was asked to develop two prototype versions, one with a conventional takeoff and landing, or CTOL, and another with S-slash-VTOL capability. The McDonnell Douglas concept aircraft was rejected due to the complexity of its design and potential implications for the desired performance of the JSF. Each company was awarded $750 million to develop their concept prototypes and their preferred weapon system concept, or PWSC. The funding was awarded to prevent the companies from bankrupting themselves to win the contract. Lockheed Martin won the System Development and Demonstration Award. The competition came down to Boeing's X-32 and Lockheed Martin X-35A and X-35C. During the demonstration phase, the Lockheed Martin X-35A and X-35C outperformed the Boeing X-32 by a large margin. The competition came down to the STOL/VTOL capability and the ability of the aircraft to optimize performance during takeoff and landing phases of flight. The Lockheed Martin's high-performance lifting fan achieved a takeoff roll of less than 500 feet, or 150 meters. The aircraft was able to fly supersonic cruise and landed vertically, excelling in performance. Meanwhile, the Boeing's X-32 engine suffered from hot air circulation issues closer to the ground. As a result, the engine's thrust performance was lowered, causing the engine to overheat. And so, Lockheed Martin's F-35 Lightning II eventually became the outcome of the JSF program. Our fourth thing to know is that the JSF was a jointly funded program which saw nine countries take part in the joint effort. Participating nations were the United States, obviously, and it was joined by the United Kingdom, Canada, Italy, the Netherlands, Turkey, Australia, Denmark, and Norway. Participating in the JSF program meant that each country had plans to purchase a certain number of fighter jets from the program. In July 2019, the United States removed Turkey from the list of participating allies after its acquisition of the Russian S-400 missile system. Turkey had initially planned to buy approximately 100 JSFs through the program. According to an official write-up from the Joint Strike Fighter program, the F-35 remains the cornerstone of the future fighter fleet. It is the world's most lethal, survivable, and connected joint strike fighter. It enables the warfighter to dominate the skies in the most challenging combat environments against the world's most unpredictable adversaries. The blurb goes on to say that the F-35 was designed to replace a multitude of aging fourth-generation US and international platforms with unmatched fifth-generation capabilities. As for Turkey, despite its ties with Russia, it remains a US ally via NATO. These days, its Khan fighter is attempting to rival America's F-35. Next, the F-35 Lightning II has a Joint Program Office, or JPO. This office leads the lifecycle program management of the three F-35 variants, the F-35A, F-35B, and F-35C. F-35A is the conventional variant, while the F-35B has VTOL capability, and the F-35C is specialized for use on aircraft carriers. As highlighted by the Government Accountability Office, the F-35's price per unit, including ancillary costs like depot maintenance, ground support equipment, and spare parts, is as follows: $110.3 million per F-35A, $135.8 million per F-35B, and $117.3 million per F-35C. The variants and their different capabilities make the jet suitable for multiple branches of the military, including the US Air Force, US Navy, and US Marine Corps. Differing capabilities also offer more choice for international partners and foreign military sales customers. Speaking of customers, the F-35 has racked up thousands of orders to date. This includes nearly 1,800 F-35As from the US Air Force alone. The US Navy and Marine Corps ordered several hundred for themselves as well. Other countries have much smaller orders that are in the dozens. And where do these jets come from? Well, the F-35's main final assembly facility can be found in Fort Worth, Texas. However, a second international FARCO or final assembly and checkout facility can be found in Cameri, Italy. Cameri was the first of two fully operational international F-35 production sites, and it's where the first internationally built F-35 was delivered in December 2015. The second FARCO site is located in Nagoya, Japan. The most recent news regarding international assembly is that Switzerland will domestically assemble four F-35A fighter jets as part of its purchase from the United States. As reported at the end of June 2024, the arrangement is part of a knowledge and technology transfer deal. After they are assembled in Switzerland, they'll be flown to Cameri, Italy for final acceptance. The final interesting thing to note about the Joint Strike Fighter program is that it has been a very costly and problematic endeavor. Indeed, according to a Government Accountability Office report from December 2023, it's estimated that it'll cost over $1.7 trillion to buy, operate, and sustain the aircraft. More recent reporting from April 2024 suggests the cost will exceed $2 trillion now, partially due to inflation. This makes the F-35 the most expensive weapon system in US history. The high cost of the program, unfortunately, has not translated into a reliable machine. Indeed, the F-35 has become well associated with technical problems and resulting low mission-capable rates. According to Air and Space Forces magazine, the main drivers of critical failures were troubleshooting, including software stability, attaching hardware, repairing wires/tubes/ducts/fiber optics, throttle grip, aircraft memory device, low observability, and issues with the type standby flight display, refueling door, and position light. Making matters worse, the fix times for critical failures was reported to be double the operational requirement for the Air Force, nearly three times for the Marine Corps, and more than double for the Navy. Hopefully, as the program continues to mature, these issues will continue to be ironed out. What are your thoughts on the Joint Strike Fighter concept? Was it a good idea to develop a single fighter jet to serve in various roles for different branches of the military? Let us know what you think by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.